Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use your CamRanger 2 to do a more advanced bracketing or HDR sequence with your Sony, Canon, Nikon, or Fujifilm camera. Here we have the Nikon Z6 connected to a CamRanger. It's wirelessly connected to this iPad running the CamRanger 2 app. Now it's important to understand how the CamRanger does the advanced bracketing. Unlike the camera's built-in bracketing, the CamRanger is actually changing the camera's exposure parameters. So, to be able to do that, we have to have the camera set to manual exposure mode, which we already do here. So we can go ahead and get started with the HDR tab. This brings up a number of options, first of which is the property. Because the CamRanger is changing exposure values, we need to select which camera property to change. Your options are aperture, shutter speed, and ISO. Most typically, you choose shutter speed, so let's stick with that. Next up is the midpoint. This selects the exposure for the middle of our bracketed sequence. And you can see the listing of all the different shutter speed options. We'll go ahead and we'll leave it on 1 over 60. Next is the step size, which is by how many stops to change the exposure between each image capture. You can see the options are 1/3 of a stop up to 3 stops. We'll set it to 1 stop. Lastly is the number of shots, how many shots to take within our sequence. The maximum number of shots is actually calculated based on the rest of your settings. Right now it's 15, and you can see on the range of shots it's going to take, it's 1 over 8,000. To 2 seconds, and the camera doesn't go any faster than 1 over 8,000, so that's why we're limited to the number of shots we are. As an example, if we change the step size to 1/3 of a stop, we'd be able to take more shots, and you can see, sure enough, we can take 43 shots. We'll set it back to 5. We'll also set our step size back to 1. Now I'll go ahead and capture a sequence, and it shows it'll go from 1 over 250 to 1 over 15. So let's go ahead and hit start, and you can see how fast that goes. You can see our images have been captured, and indeed, the exposure increases with each shot. Now, especially with the newer Nikons, it's pretty fast, no more than about a half a second between captures. Canon and Fuji are a little slower, just under a second or so between captures. And unfortunately, we're a little more limited with how quickly we can capture with Sony. And depending on your setup, it's more like 3 to 5 seconds between shots. Let's go over some of the more advanced options. So you'll note right now that the shutter speed is 1 over 15 on the camera. If we want to copy that value over from the camera to the HDR tab, you go ahead and hit the copy button. And you can see the midpoint changed from 1 over 60 to 1 over 15. This save button on the other side can be used to save and restore HDR sequences. This can be useful if there's one or two that you use frequently. So for example, we can select this bottom one and say that we want to load it, and those settings from the previous sequence were loaded. We can also, we select the time lapse tab. You can see there's an HDR field that you can toggle on and off. If you take a time-lapse sequence and HDR is toggled on, instead of taking a single image at each interval, it'll actually take the full HDR sequence at each interval. So you can make some interesting time-lapses there. Another feature within the settings that we can adjust is that midpoint. So if we go to controls and workflows, and then HDR start point, you can see right now it's set to the default, which is mid. We can also set it to high and low. So instead of that midpoint indicating the middle of the exposure range, we can have that value indicate the high or the low exposure. So for example, if I set it to low, I'll go back to HDR, and now you see still called midpoint, but you can think of it as start point, is 1 over 8, and you can see our range is 1 over 8 to 1 over 2. So the lowest value is 1 over 8, which we have set there. So that can be a little bit easier sometimes depending on your workflow. Instead of having it as the middle of the exposure range, having it at the least or most exposed value. Additionally, you can also do bulb HDR. So if I change our shutter speed here to bulb, you can see now the start point is listed as a time. And so, for example, we have it set at 1 second, three shots, step size of one, and the resulting sequence will be 0.5 to 2.0 seconds. So that's another interesting way that you can do HDR combined with bulb. Well, I hope the video was helpful, and thanks for watching.